Kershaw. Nick's my guest tonight. Nick, it's great to have you back in the studio. We'll be finding out what the riddle's all about a bit later on. You're not going to get out of that whatsoever.
Well, listen, what about this riddle? Because, I mean, 6 months ago, we were reviewing the album at the time, and, you know, we wanted to know about the riddle, what it was all about. And, you know, for those last 6 months, I've been getting so much mail about this, and of course you're not going to come up with the goods, or are you? I mean, I want you to. I mean, I don't want to have to fight about this, Nick. I mean, you know, going back to the song again, you know, I've got two strong arms, and you're going to have to use them if you don't tell us what the riddle's all about now.
I've got a very big security guard in that control room.
Yeah, you know, there's a lock on this door here as well, which I'm now going to do.
Oh my God.
There you are. So come on, what is the riddle all about? Tell us what the story's all about.
Right.
Go on. Be a good sport, Nick.
Well, I mean, think of all the people got these wonderful ideas about what they think the riddle is about. They've got these beautiful images in their head about what the riddle is about. And I'm going to tell everybody what it's about, and it's going to spoil it for everybody. I mean, I can't do that.
No. Come on, listen. We've been listening and playing that record for 6 months now. How can it spoil anything? Come on, Nick. Now, don't let me down. You know, I've only got 5 more minutes to go, and I've got to get the answer out of you for everybody who's been writing.
What can I talk about for 5 minutes?
No, I don't want you to talk about anything else. We've got to know what the riddle is all about. Nick! Now, come on. Now, I've been waiting 6 months for this. Now, come on. I want this fair now. 5 minutes I've got, and you've got 2 of those 5 to tell us what it's all about. Please.
I'll tell you what, Nicholas. I'll give you a slightly bigger clue. There's a clue on the back concerning a gentleman called Marcel Duchamp.
Right.
And I suppose I could tell you who Marcel Duchamp is if nobody's been bothered to find out.
Well, that's a start, right? That's a start.
Okay.
Well,
Marcel
right.
Duchamp was an artist who was around about the 20s and 30s. I think he died about 20 years ago. And he did lots of interesting sculptures and art pieces.
Mm.
And he was involved in a movement called the Dadaists. And the movement was called Dada, named after a guy called Dada, funny enough. So if you look in your art history books concerning Dadaism, that's D-A-D-A-I-S-M.
Mm-hmm. Get those of that.
Yeah, we got that.
Dadaism.
Dadaism.
Dadaism. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Right.
It will make very interesting reading. And the point is not exactly about the man, Marcel Duchamp himself, but his motivation for doing things.
But what's that got to do with these lyrics, like, near a tree by a river, there's a hole in the ground?
Well, there is.
As an old man of Arran goes round and around.
He does.
And his mind is a beacon in the veil of the night. For a strange kind of fashion, there's a wrong and a right, but he'll never, never fight over you.
You
still haven't got the drift,
the
Nick.
Drift?
Yeah.
Well, it's there in black and white. I don't understand. I mean,
well, none of us understand. That's why I'm fighting you for this.
Actually, I haven't read this for a while. It's a bit weird, isn't it? No, Bruno, you've got so much out of me. I mean, you're so privileged to have all this information.
What, Dadaism?
Dadaism. You can't even say it.
Dadaism. Dadaism.
It's the biggest clue ever given to the world's population, and you're complaining about that. I've given it on your program. I mean, what can you say?
I'm disappointed.
No. You've got. I mean, you can work it out for that. It's so close to the final solution. The final solution. My God.
Has that given it away?
No. Well, it is almost. Mm. I mean, almost.
I'm not going to get any more out of it.
No.
And that's it.
Yes.
We're never going to be friends again, then, are we?
Well.
I mean, we're going to break this friendship now, aren't we? I mean, you know, I'm going to finish this interview altogether, aren't I? I'm not going to carry it anymore, because that's all you're going to give me. A little bit about Dadaism. Nicholas!
You still can't get it right. Dadaism.
Living.
Did I tell Simon Bates? Did I tell Mike Reed? Did I?
No, but I mean, they haven't sort of questioned you as many times as I have, and I've been nice, haven't I?
You've been very good. Have you ever thought of joining an organisation called the Spanish Inquisition? They're very popular in the 16th century.
Really?
Yes.
Nik Kershaw's Don Quixote. Thanks again, Nick, for coming in. A mate of mine just brought down an encyclopedia from the office upstairs. Now Nick's gone, I can try and look at what Dadaism actually means. According to this here, it says it's a 20th century abstract art form, which I think Nick said. Yeah, a bit like a toilet seat on the wall. Ooh, I like that, Henry. Ooh, that's nice. Stuff like that, like a pile of bricks sprayed in metal flake paint. Would be this Dadaism. Still don't understand what the riddle's all about, though.